Hello guys, this is Dr. Mora again, and today I want to show you this new case review.
You see on the video, we have this case in which we program some posterior expansion. Let me play this video and maybe play it slower so you can have an idea. So we made some expansion of the posterior teeth. We proclined initially the anterior teeth. We created space for the rotation. But for me, we made some mistakes in the treatment plan that we rotate the canines till the very end. We should have started with some distal out movements and then mesialine movement. This is one of the mistakes that I found. The other one, maybe we made too much expansion. Probably the bone of the patient did not allow to express completely. So lastly, I'm going to show you how we made the proclination initially and then the intrusion, which the intrusion was not achieved. And now let's jump directly. You can see the intrusion was left at the very end. And so let's see how the treatment plan. And the lower arch, we didn't have much movements, very, very light movements. And let's see what happened. Let's go to the case. I have some superimposition images, which they look pretty good if you check the how the anterior teeth got proclined. It's very, very, very nice. You can see the blue one is the initial one and the gray one is the refinement. So we did achieve expansion. We did not achieve 100% of the expansion, but we did achieve some expansion. You can see the slight retraction that I always talk about, 7. It did very good. We did have some expansion and we also maintained the cusp relation, so we did not have an intrusion of the palatal cusp, which is very important because we need to control the torque while we are expanding, which is something that I always show in my, as you can see, it's something that I always show to in my trainings, how to control that correctly. Okay, and the other thing that I want to show you is, let me just make this image a little bit bigger. So the other thing that I want to show you is how much the difference between the first design, and you can see it's minimal changes. The canine did not rotate correctly, which is something that I point from the very beginning. We need to make distal out movement and then mesialine. In the previous design, we made expansion initially and we made the whole rotation of the mesialine. This was a mistake, but we are going to correct it. So you can see the movements. The red one is the step 31. This case was 31 aligner case. And the gray one is the initial scan. So you can see we did have expansion, but we missed a little bit. Maybe with a little bit of overcorrection, we could have achieved 100% of the expansion. But if we compare with the first scans, you can see the blue one is the initial one. Gray one is where we are right now. And the red one is the 31 step of the design. Okay. So we do have movements, we do have some delays, but we have very good results. Check out how the proclination went very good, but then check the intrusion movement. Even if we separate the intrusion movement, when we have significant intrusion, probably we should use some mini screws, because it seems like even if we make the proclination and the intrusion correctly, if we separate these movements, even like that, the intrusion is not achieved. So very important to consider this, to place your beautiful mini screw so you can have better results. So I think this was a very good comparison. In the lower arch, we don't have much to talk and there is not much movements involved. The case went pretty good in the lower arch as well. If you can see, if you compare the movement, we did have some intrusion here in the lower arch, some extrusion of the posterior, which was something that we were looking for. But then the rest, it was very minimal movements, just slight expansion that we did achieve over here. Over here, you can see it better, but nothing important in the lower arch. But what I want to point is how beautiful the proclination was achieved and how we did not achieve the intrusion of upper incisors. So thank you so much for this. If you like this content, please don't forget about following me in my social medias and in my YouTube channel. And we're also giving a training here in Barcelona the 3rd of May 2025. It's gonna be 8 hours of full biomechanics. So join me in my training, and if you have any questions, please, you can write it down in the comment section. Thank you so much and have a beautiful day.